Catch Light.
Yes, another treasure hunt, going back through the hours and hours and hours of audio we recorded while we were writing You Know What They Mean, and we're tracing the trails of how Catch Light was made.
And there's a lot. It just seems like we wasted so much time. But we'll get into all that. The first place this originated was in the sessions we did in Chris's house. Chris Bell's little man.
That's right.
The whole idea of that session was it would be all MIDI. It was instrument free. So it was just all of us playing MIDI. That was an idea that I pushed really hard for. It seemed like it was going to be stupid for a while.
Yeah.
Because the first 2 days were relatively unproductive. There's a lot of bizarre, pointless stuff. But we did get the seeds of both Catch Light and Hold Me In.
Not bad.
Yeah.
Two singles.
So here's a session.
That's awesome.
Yeah, like we revised the instrumentation, obviously, to like live in our band instrumentation world. But other than that, like, it really sounds not that dissimilar to what we wound up with. So we pretty much got the vibe of the chorus.
You can see why we wanted to work with it more, because like that is the first version of it.
Yeah.
And it's like a good thing.
Yeah.
Which is not how it normally works out.
Yeah, with Bone Rage, the very first thing was a little odd. And then we got another functional part of it, the bridge.
Oh, really? That's nice.
It's very similar to what we wound up with in the final version. So now we're going to jump ahead in time to August 2018. That's the next
March.
Time.
Wow.
That we really worked on this song. And a lot has happened since then.
Right. Gavin broke his leg. We did a whole tour.
He's out of commission.
We played a lot of some of the other songs over and over again live, but we haven't even started this one. Huh?
This session here is from, it's from Maine.
Mm-hmm.
When we were doing writing sessions there. And this is without Gavin. So this is where Gavin would just send us like drum loops, and we would put stuff over them.
Different times.
But it's kind of cool because I think, like, you see, we definitely wouldn't have the first verse that we have for the song if it wasn't for Gavin breaking his leg, because I don't think we would have done this thing with the drum machine. This is this is where the kind of the verse idea first pops up.
Whoa. Is this a bass loop from the email?
I think he played this bass riff.
Definitely. Definitely.
So yeah.
Oh, I remember that now. I do remember playing that.
Yeah.
Turned out way different.
So you kind of hear like the little, little seed there, and you hear like a little of the vocal melody too. Is it Jessica? Oh yeah.
Yeah. And she went home and developed.
Yeah.
This one.
So now I think we're back more in the land of like, wow, we turned that into a good sounding song. I think we just zoomed in on that bass riff, if I remember right. So let's get out of that session. There's going to be a lot of arguing about tempo.
Oh, cool. Oh, which is a big deal in this song, yeah.
It's an argument that really still isn't 100% resolved. So now we jump ahead a couple weeks to September. We're back in the studio at the record company. Cut. And Gavin's still out. Jessica came in with the lyrics. So yeah, this is where Chris was playing this like little drum pattern on his synth.
Oh, that's it.
Yeah.
Wow.
So then you put, that's just you putting the bass riff on the guitar.
The octave pitch shift.
Yeah, that really is like pretty much it.
Yeah.
So now we have the verse, the chorus, the bridge, what the hell?
Right, why did it take so long?
What the hell are we doing? Because we didn't really have the song like ready to play until, well, I mean, I guess we need Gavin to come back. That's a really key component.
We kept thinking Gavin was going to come back, and then we get bad news that he couldn't come back yet.
Sorry, I do not speak unless I'm...
Oh, okay, so this is synth comes in.
It makes sense if you don't have acoustic drums coming in to have the form be a much smoother ramp.
Yeah. Well, even like, I think relatively late, even as late as like the November Haken tour, we're talking about delaying the acoustic drum entrance further, I think. Or at least I was talking about that and pushing.
So your part, that came in.
It's at a different timing, I think, than what it wound up being. But yeah, that.
Yeah.
Yeah, remember I'd accidentally like discovered that when I like made some like weird patch shifter or something. So, you know, my guitar is just plugged in to an interface, and it was just like on a completely clean setting, but with the preamp gain just like way too high, so it's just completely clipping.
Mm-hmm.
And then for some reason my low string was tuned down super low,
mm-hmm.
and just like that sound with it clipping, and the super subby low string. It's just really cool. Forms are already, I think, pretty much there for the first half. Slower.
I'm glad it's faster than this now.
Yeah.
This makes it sleepy.
Yeah. Yeah, like the drum machine's cool up to a point. And then it's not so right for the song. That's what I think was so frustrating about a lot of the writing when Gavin was out, was like, you know, if you play this whole thing back, which I'm not going to subject us to, it's just not an interesting thing to listen to, because it's just missing something that's really supposed to be in there, like acoustic drums. And so we're just like spending all this time just kind of imagining what the arrangements were going to be like with acoustic drums and guessing. And but you know, that's well and good, like we made some progress doing that, but we weren't getting that reward of like actually hearing the song sound like a cool song. So let's see, do we have the bridge formed? Pretty similar minus what you're doing.
Terrible.
You can see how it can become a cool song, but it's like, what's gonna happen when we add drums? Let's open up the next one, see where it goes to.
Let's keep it going. Bring back those memories.
So this is just a week later at the record company.
Not much time.
And now we're down to just recording stereo mics. Instead of the full multi-track, because we're kind of running out of things to do at this point.
Written in.
Yeah, you can even like tell just like the way you're playing it is like with less energy.
Yeah,
Courtney singing with.
My elbow. It's like an eye roll.
This one's too depressing to listen to. I think every writing process is gonna have difficulties one way or another.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like a question of how you adapt to them and get through them. Right. Hopefully this next session that we open up is a little more fun. Once Gavin came back, writing started being fun again.
I'm sorry I do not speak unless I'm...
Yeah, this is just really dragging. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think you are like the most vocal member of the fast camp.
Mm-hmm.
I was the most vocal member of the slow camp.
Mm-hmm.
It was a really good instance of how kind of compromise can be great sometimes. Because I think the song wound up being faster than I had wanted. And I think it wound up being slower than you had wanted.
Yeah.
And I think it wound up being a really good tempo. That
I agree.
Works really well.
Yeah.
Yeah. So much time with a drum machine on this song really had an impact on what the groove wound up being.
Because
I don't know if the groove would have been so straight ahead if we hadn't been writing with right. The drum machine for so long. Here you can like really hear what touring a song does. Like really all that much different from what like we play on the album,
mm-hmm.
but the groove is just not nearly as strong, and we just kind of feel mm-hmm. clumsy and plod, and part of it's a tempo.
The blending isn't there. I find that Tor really helps me get the tone right, and it's not even necessarily what I'm dialing in on my amp or anything, it's just like where on the strings I'm plucking yeah. and in what pickup, and when am I palm muting, when am I switching patches.
Yeah, it just helps you refine all those little things.
Like the exact way we transitioned and when.
I think like people, you know, talk about like the weird things we do, you know, crazy ideas for forms or like, you know, throwing in a section you wouldn't expect in the middle of a song. Mm-hmm. Like the part that I think is impressive is that we find a way to like make it work with the transitions, that we find transitions. Mm-hmm. That can have yeah. those sections make sense.
Good game.
Good review.
Good catch light.